I make this video coming off of some very noticeable breakthroughs. After making the video last night, which is go vertical, go vertical, go vertical, it was nighttime and I lay down to go to sleep. I was just lying there on my back and I became aware that I didn't have a personal perspective anymore. And I had a non-personal perspective. And I said, wow, my personal perspective has vanished. And I said, wow, this is great. This is good. And it was fine. It was no problem at all. You know, that is just one of the breakthroughs. And then this morning, it was like bubbles popping in me. So it's like boop, boop, boop. Each one like a bubble of clarity. Suddenly it popped and I was suddenly clear. I'm like, wow. So there is really success going on here. I was aware that I don't have to harmonize anything. I don't have to clear out anything. Don't have to fear anything. Don't need to harmonize anything. Don't need to clear out anything. Don't need to do anything. And that in the video, go vertical, go vertical, go vertical, I talked about how you have bubbles in a drink and the bubbles come up to the surface. And right at the surface, a lot of times they stop and they don't pop right away. And then suddenly, poof, they'll pop like that. Literally, that's what I was experiencing. I was experiencing these sort of psychic bubbles in my mind suddenly poof, popping. This is very nice, very cool. So, something is working, for sure, for sure. So, it's not presumptuous for me to continue to share this information and these practices. We're getting somewhere with this. There's no question about it. The Holy Grail to shift out of personal perspective, I realize what is personal perspective but a prison? Personal perspective is the notion that we are limited by what our senses can sense. And think about that. You're sitting somewhere and all you're seeing is a room and you're hearing what's in the room and that's it. Is that supposed to be our awareness? Really? Personal awareness is that's what we are created for? Personal awareness? I thought we're created as spirit. As truth. I am not a body. I am free. I am as God created me. This is the testimony of the saviors of the world. So, I was aware that my awareness was not bound to my physical body senses at all. Here comes another chapter. I am free. I am as God created me. I relax my mind. I release my thoughts. I let them go. I relax my mind. I release my thoughts. I let them go. All these thoughts are based on the belief in a limited perspective, limiting our perspective. I was not bound. I realized I am not bound by my sensory parameters, by the body's senses. And it was just there. I just said, hey, you know, just I was just aware of it. That's it. It was that simple. So the focus on going vertical, going vertical, going vertical had this very, very tremendous upliftment and shift of perspective. My perspective had shifted even in doing the video. I lay down to go to sleep. I realized I don't have a personal perspective. I don't have a personal perspective anymore. And I said, I'm fine with that. This is great. I should have done more of that. I said, oh, I love this. I'm so grateful. This is wonderful. But I was kind of like amazed by it at first. Now, I realize that personal perspective has recoalesced, so to speak, today. But You know, it's very, it must be very close, you know, to. I don't know, I'm not going to try and measure anything here. So we're going to continue here. These are the turnover times in the world. And you either go with the personal perspective or you free yourself from the personal perspective. All the great teachers in history have told us that we can free ourselves from the personal perspective. From the perspective of a person, the body, person, we can free ourselves from that. And I've always known that this is true. So, take them at their word. Take them at their word. We can do it. And take them at their word that there's help for us. Holy Spirit, the grace of God helps us. You know, believe it, accept it. And don't argue against it. I try not to waste time trying to get into discussions and arguments and etc. Because for me, it's a certainty. Absolutely. It's just a little bit of will. Just a little willingness to go vertical is all that it takes. Just a little willingness. And I had that last night, and I shifted out of my personal perspective, which was wonderful. It wasn't head over heels wonderful, because it was very subtle and very mild. But I said, hey, I like this. This is great. There was no I to say I like this. It wasn't like the personality say I like this. I just saying, being free of the personal perspective is a great idea. This is natural. This is what we are. This is natural. It's totally unnatural to bind ourselves to personal perspective, the senses. It's an attempt to fail. We are trying to create failure of reality. We're trying to get reality to fail as what it is. We're trying to say it's a failure. We can make it fail. And we cannot. But we can pursue that objective, which is what we have been doing. We've been pursuing that objective for a long, long time. Now, I believe the work that's being done here is actually working. So what is that work? We're using terms to get ourselves ready, emphasizing how tremendous it is to be freed of the personal perspective. And so I'm going to keep doing that. I'll try to keep doing that here because it is working. And again, so let me talk about how it felt a little bit. There's no anxiety. There was no feeling of nervousness or anxiety or anything. It was like interest. I was just like observing and saying, this is really cool. This is really cool. Yeah, very welcome. I welcome this. This is very welcome. Not the personal perspective welcoming it, but that which transcends the personal perspective. Personal perspective is attempt to fail. Spirit is trying to create failure. And so, it's trying to progressively limit us, and tell us we're nothing more than animals. Great way to enslave people, isn't it? Which is what the world is doing, feeding everyone's senses to the max, feeding the senses, making people happy with their senses, what they can get through the senses, right? That's what's happening. The sex, the drugs, the rock and roll, and all the consumer, materialistic consumerism, all the entertainment, all this stuff, okay, is feeding the body, the senses, to say, look, being limited to a personal perspective is fun. It's fun. Look at all the sexy, beautiful people, you know. Look at all the gaudy clothes. Look at all the, you know, the wonderful entertainments and the you know, all this stuff. And if you don't feel so great, here's some medication, here's some drugs, here's this and that. Nothing is the world doing about feeding the mind. It's all about feeding the senses. (Clears throat) Now, we don't have to starve the senses, but we have to purposefully feed the mind, feed the mind, feed the mind with great ideas, great practices to enable us to just make this effortless shift out of the personal perspective. I wasn't even aware of any shift, okay? I just lay down, I was just lying there, and then it just dawned on me. It says, I don't really have a personal perspective. It was like that. It's the easiest of dawnings. It's just, I said, oh, no, I don't know when it left or when it, any shift or anything. It just wasn't there. It just wasn't there. No panic, no worry, no concern. I said, yeah, finally, it's not there. Good. I hope it doesn't come back. You know, that's how I felt. I hope it doesn't come back. But I know it does come back to some extent. It's here to some extent, but I'm not trying to measure it. Okay, let's not measure anything. Not measure anything. Don't calculate. Don't collect data. Keep faith with the words of the great ones, the great awakened ones, the ones who have shifted out of personal perspective. There have been those who have done this. And they relate and they tell us, you can do it too. In fact, you have to do it. Because we can never be a success at failure. We cannot fail to be what we truly are. It's impossible. We can pretend symbolically to be different, but we are still absolutely exactly as God created us. I am not a body, I am free, for I am exactly as God created me. I relax my mind, I release my thoughts, I let them go, and I don't invite them back. I do not invite them back. And I don't chase after them to see where they're going, to measure how fast they're running. No data collecting is necessary. No harmonizing is necessary. That's one of the bubbles above. No harmonizing. I don't need to harmonize anything. This moment already is in perfect harmony. Why? Because it's all inclusive. There's nothing outside it whatsoever. So it's the totality. Right now is the totality of everything. Every moment contains everything, both manifest and unmanifest. Every single moment. Thus, there is not a moment that is lacking something, and the next moment adds to it, and the next moment adds to it as far as lack. No, it's not like that at all. Each moment has the totality of what we want to experience. That very moment, and the total, both experiencing manifest and unmanifest, the complete total potentiality and reality of creation is contained in each and every moment, and moments are not welded together. We're free. We have perfect freedom each moment to choose what it is we want to experience. This is the vertical perspective, and this is the true, true perspective. Now, the experience of not having a personal perspective was not some sort of giddy experience. It wasn't giddy. Wasn't overwhelming. It was very mild kind of thing. It's just, okay. But it was a very mild type of experience, right? It was so I'm sure that as this dawns, it will be like a mountain of gold, really. It really is. So, to practice, to take the edge off of it, which is what we're doing, we're taking the edge off of this experience where we no longer have a personal perspective. Just think about that. Don't have a person, we have a God perspective. I said, what I experienced was the perspective of all upon all. There's perspective of God, knowing everything, aware of everything. That's the perspective. It's very mild, though. And so the thoughts of a person, my thoughts of what thoughts I've generated as I'm thinking I'm a person, I need to have a personal perspective. Why do we need to have a personal perspective? Why not have the perspective of everything, knowing everything? Isn't that the right perspective? Isn't a personal perspective an attempt to limit true perspective? Isn't an attempt to try and generate a failure, ultimately? It is. That's the purpose of existence. It is a vast entropic failure dream. It's a dream of failure, actually. But we can dream a dream within the dream. And that's a dream of non-failure. So let us, knowing that we are not a body, we are free, we are as God created us, relaxing our mind, releasing our thoughts, and letting them go, and not chasing after them, accepting the vertical shift, and practicing in our expectations and in the flavor of it. We are practicing just how great it's going to be. And once we really practice this and we're comfortable thinking and expecting along these terms, I expect that it'll be easy for us. And we'll say, oh, that wasn't bad. Yeah, it's not a problem. It's not a problem at all. Whereas if we're not ready for it, if we don't practice, if we don't expect it, then we're going to say, wow, it's just too rich for my blood or something. But we're not going to be among those who say it's too rich for our blood. We're going to say it's just right for our blood. Just right. I love the massiveness of it. I love that massive mountain of gold. I love that massive mountain of gold. Okay? This is our attitude now. I love that massive mountain of gold. I love that super fantastic mountain of gold. I love that tremendous mountain of gold. I just love that huge, huge mountain of gold. I just adore that immense, immense mountain of gold. Let me see here. I'm going to pull up something here. One moment, please, to make it even better. Just feel, I love that massive mountain of gold. I love that massive mountain of gold. I love that massive mountain of gold. Mm-hmm. Well, let's see. Finding exactly what I want, but okay, one second, I am going to find this. Alright, I had it all along. So I absolutely love this, that great, great mountain of gold that I'm seeing. I just absolutely love that great mountain of joy. I take utmost joy in that monumental mountain of gold. I take the utmost joy in that monumental mountain of gold. I am totally rejoicing in this fantastic mountain of gold. I am absolutely rejoicing in this fantastic mountain of gold. I am so happy seeing this amazing mountain of gold. I am rejoicing. I am totally rejoicing as I see this exceptional mountain of gold. Rejoicing to see this exceptional mountain of gold. I am taking the utmost delight in this terrific mountain of gold. I am just taking the utmost delight in this absolutely terrific mountain, massive mountain of gold. I am feeling such bliss as I see this wonderful mountain of gold. I am in bliss seeing this wonderful mountain of scintillating gold. I take great satisfaction at this astounding mountain of gold. I take the greatest satisfaction at this absolutely astounding mountain of gold. I am truly blessed. I am truly blessed with this marvelous mountain of gold. I am truly blessed with this marvelous, marvelous, marvelous mountain of gold. I give thanks. I truly give thanks for this epic, epic, epic mountain of gold. I truly give thanks for this epic mountain of gold. I have the utmost appreciation. I am feeling the utmost appreciation for this boundless, boundless mountain of gold. I'm feeling the utmost appreciation for this boundless mountain of gold. I am feeling total gratitude. I am feeling total gratitude for this mammoth mountain of gold. I am feeling the utmost gratitude for this mammoth mountain of gold. I am feeling such amazing buoyancy seeing this prodigious mountain of gold. I am feeling such buoyancy seeing this prodigious mountain of gold. I am in the greatest of good humor, really the greatest of good humor, seeing this infinite mountain of gold, this infinite mountain of gold. I am in the highest of high spirits, seeing this colossal mountain of gold. I am in such great high spirits, seeing this colossal mountain of gold. I feel so totally reassured, seeing this legendary, legendary mountain of gold. I am totally reassured seeing this legendary mountain of gold. I have the utmost high outlook now, the best outlook, seeing this glorious mountain of gold. I have the finest outlook now, seeing this glorious mountain of gold. I feel so beatific, seeing this illustrious mountain of gold. I feel so beatific, seeing this illustrious mountain of gold. I feel the utmost gratification, seeing this giant, giant, giant mountain of gold. I feel the utmost gratification seeing this giant, giant, giant mountain of gold. I feel perfectly poised. I feel so perfectly poised seeing this titanic mountain of gold. I feel absolutely poised seeing this titanic mountain of gold. I feel the utmost elation seeing this untold mountain of gold. I feel the utmost elation seeing this untold mountain of gold. I feel just wonderfully buzzed. I feel this wonderful buzz seeing this measureless mountain of gold. I feel the utmost wonderful buzz seeing this measureless mountain of radiant gold. I feel the greatest exaltation seeing this unlimited mountain of gold. I feel the utmost exaltation experiencing this unlimited mountain of gold. I am truly sparkling, just sparkling, as I'm experiencing this wide open mountain of gold. I'm just absolutely sparkling, experiencing this wide open mountain of gold. I feel so absolutely vibrant, just wonderfully vibrant, experiencing this incalculable mountain of gold. I feel so vibrant experiencing this incalculable mountain of gold. I just love this everlasting mountain of gold. I just love this everlasting mountain of gold. I just love experiencing this everlasting mountain of gold. I'm in this wonderful wordlessness, experiencing this godly mountain of gold. I'm in this wonderful wordlessness, experiencing this godly mountain of gold. I am simply transported by this ceaseless mountain of gold. I'm simply transported, experiencing this ceaseless mountain of gold. I am absolutely elevated, seeing this eternal mountain of gold. I am absolutely elevated, experiencing this eternal mountain of gold. I am absolutely elevated, experiencing this eternal mountain of gold. I am enraptured, experiencing this constant mountain of gold. I feel enraptured, experiencing this constant mountain of gold. I am just struck through and through. I feel struck through and through, experiencing this endless mountain of gold. I am struck through and through, experiencing this endless mountain of gold. I am in seventh heaven, experiencing this unfathomable mountain of gold. I'm in seventh heaven, experiencing this unfathomable mountain of gold. I am in paradise. I am in paradise, experiencing this unbounded mountain of gold. I feel paradisical, experiencing this unbounded mountain of gold. I feel such gladness. I feel such gladness, experiencing this unfading mountain of gold. I feel such gladness, experiencing this unfading mountain of gold. I am euphoric, experiencing this permanent mountain of gold. I am euphoric. I feel so euphoric experiencing this permanent mountain of gold. I am absolutely jubilant to experience this indestructible mountain of gold. I feel jubilation. I feel such jubilation experiencing this indestructible mountain of gold. I feel exhilaration experiencing this irrefutable mountain of gold. I feel totally exhilarated experiencing this irrefutable mountain of gold. I am so inspired experiencing this unassailable mountain of gold. I feel such inspiration experiencing this unassailable mountain of gold. I am on cloud nine, truly on cloud nine, experiencing this incontestable mountain of gold. I feel on cloud nine, experiencing this incontestable mountain of gold. I am enlivened by seeing this invincible mountain of gold. I feel so enlivened experiencing this invincible mountain of gold. I am galvanized by experiencing this self-evident mountain of gold. I am totally galvanized by experiencing this self-evident mountain of gold. I feel exuberant experiencing this supreme mountain of gold. I feel the greatest exuberance experiencing this supreme mountain of gold. I am at peace experiencing this clear-cut mountain of gold. I feel so peaceful. I feel so peaceful experiencing this clear-cut mountain of gold. I am ecstatic. I am ecstatic experiencing this awesome mountain of gold. I am ecstatic experiencing this awesome mountain of gold. I am enchanted experiencing this breathtaking mountain of gold. I am so absolutely enchanted seeing this breathtaking mountain of gold. I am head over heels seeing this wondrous mountain of gold. I am just head over heels experiencing this wondrous mountain of gold. I am just devoted to seeing this surpassing mountain of gold. I feel such devotion towards this surpassing mountain of gold. I am simply raving about this expansive mountain of gold. I am just raving about this expansive mountain of gold. I am so pleased by this spacious mountain of gold. I feel such pleasure to experience this spacious mountain of gold. I simply adore this endless mountain of gold. I am feeling adoration towards this endless mountain of gold. All right then, so when we metaphorically see that mountain of gold, which is the total inclusiveness, all manifest, all unmanifest, right here, right now, that immeasurable mountain of gold, our reactions are already being smoothed out. We're smoothing our reactions out, is what we're doing. We're okay with being completely ecstatic. We're okay with being completely euphoric. We're okay with all this. Because why? It's beyond that. It's even beyond that. But we are ironing out, smoothing it out, smoothing out our expectations. So it's not all, you know, whoa, I'm ecstatic. Wait a minute. Why am I ecstatic? Back, you know, no, I'm the opposite. You know, I'm like reactive. Why am I euphoric? Oh no, I've got to be very depressed. You know, I got to go back in the personal perspective. Wait a minute, what am I doing out of the bottle? I got to get back in the bottle. Say no, I'm already prepared to be out of the bottle. I don't need to put myself back in the bottle of personal perspective. Sure, I'm euphoric. I'm ecstatic. Ecstatic. I'm jubilant. I am head over heels. I'm on cloud nine. I am just all of this, right? All of this. And more, and we'll go over some more after a little rest, a little cool down here. It's stressful to do this. And say, sure, whatever. I'm supposed to be. I'm supposed to be. I'm not a personal self. I have room to feel this way. I have reason and room to feel this way. I'm not trying to put this in the bottle of personal reaction. Not at all. It's not. So, that is the application of it. Smooths out the whole situation. Let me get some. Again, we go over our reactions. These are like reactions that we don't expect the personality to have, okay? Not on an ongoing basis. These are like peak experiences that, you know, you've read those books about peak experiences and stuff, and they say, well, if you're lucky in life, you might have one peak experience or something. Now we're talking about abiding in beyond peak experience. Peak experience relates to the personality, the body, personal perspective. We are shifting vertically, all right, and so we are abiding in beyond peak experience. We feel like $1 million every moment. Every moment I feel like $1 million. Every moment I feel like I'm walking the halls of heaven. Every moment I feel like a newborn man, a newborn woman, a newborn spirit. Every moment I feel reborn. Every moment I feel reborn. Every moment I feel I'm further along. Every moment I feel like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Every moment I feel like I know I should. Every moment I feel like I know I really should. Every moment I'm in the absolute wide open zone. I'm in the wide openness zone. Every moment I'm in the wide openness zone. Every day I get up on the right side of the bed. Every moment I get up on the right side of the bed. Every moment I feel perfect. Every moment I feel perfect. Every moment I'm up among the clouds. Every moment I am up among the clouds. Every moment has never been better. Every moment has never been better. Every moment is more than a feeling, right? It is more than any feeling. Every moment I'm up and away. Every moment I'm up and away. Every moment I'm in the nearest faraway place. Every single moment I am dwelling in the nearest faraway place. Every moment I'm footloose and fancy free. Every moment I am footloose and fancy free. Every moment I'm a free-born man. I'm a free-born man. I'm a free-born spirit. Every moment I'm a free-born spirit. Every moment, every single moment, I'm walking on sunshine. Every single moment, I am walking on sunshine. Every single moment is prime time for me. Every moment is a prime time moment for me. Every moment I'm awake and smelling the roses. Every moment I'm awake and smelling the roses. Yeah. every moment is a transcendently peak moment. Every day is this cool, cool change. Wonderful breeze. Every moment I feel this wonderful breeze. Every moment I feel the Alpha. I am the Alpha and the Omega. Every moment is the Alpha and the Omega. Every moment I'm resting in the everlasting arms. Every single moment I am resting in the everlasting arms. Every moment I'm experiencing original nature. Every moment I'm experiencing my original nature. Every single moment I feel like my day has come, my moment has come. Every single moment I feel my day has truly come. Every moment I know I've made the great escape. Every moment I'm aware that I have made the great escape. Every moment I hop a ride on the Salvation Express. Every moment I hop a ride on the Salvation Express. Every moment is like, ah. Every moment is just like, ah. Every moment is free and easy. For me, every moment is free and easy. I dwell in the free and easy moment. Every moment is rock solid steady. Every single moment is rock solid steady. Every moment I am truly walking with the Lord. Every moment I am truly walking with the One Self. Every moment I'm dwelling in the Promised Land. Every moment I am dwelling in the Promised Land. Every moment I'm flying with the wings of an eagle. Every moment I'm flying with the wings of an eagle, the mighty wings of an eagle. Every moment I realize that this truly is a wrap. This truly is a wrap. Truly is a wrap. Gone vertical. I'm not a body. I am free. I am as God created me. I relax my mind. I release my thoughts. I let them go. I do not chase after them, and I do not invite them back, because all of those thoughts have to do with personal perspective, time and space, attempts at failure, attempts to create failure. I let all go. I let all those silly attempts go, all the efforts and thoughts about it. I don't need, what thoughts do I need to think about failure? None. What do I need to harmonize about this moment? Nothing. Everything is in, already in the one harmonious relationship with all that is. That is the one relationship. Everything already is in perfect harmony with all that is. One family. It's already one harmonious family. No one's excluded. No one's excluded. Everything manifest, unfest, unmanifest is already included in this moment. So there's perfect harmony. Perfect harmony. This moment contains everything. Everything. In perfect harmony with the one relationship. With the one relationship. No loss is taking place. There is no greater, there is no lesser. So there is the harmony, is there not? Is it not? Everything's eternal life, there it is, the harmony. So we go vertical, we go vertical, we go vertical. And we do these exercises to strain ourselves. It should be a strain. You should feel strained, should feel tired at some point, because ordinary talk doesn't talk this way. We don't focus like this. How often do we say any of these things? You know, when's the last time you say to people, hey, you know what, I feel absolutely like $1,000,000 this very moment, and every single moment I feel like $1,000,000? Never. We never say these things, because we only relate to others. We've been trained to relate in terms of personal perspective. And personal perspective never reaches that. So people would say we're arrogant, we're presumptuous, we're crazy, we're cuckoo, we're over the top, you know, if we talk this way. But we are doing this as exercises to prepare ourselves to go, when we go vertical into the holy moment, the holy instant, where everything is contained in that instant. That instant is completely, totally, all one, everything. Every awareness is present in this very instant. Everything manifest and unmanifest is present in this very moment. All sharing that total inclusivity, that total support of the moment. Each moment totally supports everything. Each moment totally supports everything. All supportive. All supportive. Completely buoyant. Everything is equally completely buoyant. We don't have to harmonize anything. We don't have to clear anything out. We don't have to rearrange anything. We don't have to remember anything. We don't have to fear anything. So these are rehearsals for going vertical. And as I have witnessed too, last night I did go vertical. Just before sleep, I did go vertical. And in a mild way. But the realization was there, hey, I don't have a personal perspective. It's gone. It's gone. I didn't trash it or chop it up or tack it or anything. No, I just realized, oh, it's not there. I don't know where it went. I'm not going to try and find it. I'm not going to try and find it. It just evaporated. It just evaporated is what happened. What we're doing is we're evaporating the personal perspective here. We are literally microwaving it and evaporating it, boiling it, just evaporating it. So it's an evaporation process is what we're engaged in here. Just realize that these practices, you know, when you're evaporating something, it's like watching paint dry. You know, you just keep the heat going, and it just imperceptibly happens. Okay, and that's all that we're doing. We are evaporating the personal perspective, and that is it for this video.